And a warm welcome to the live show this Sunday night, Sunday the 30th of October. This is Scotty McClue with you saying dinky do. Lovely to be with you again, of course, and lots to talk about tonight and so little time to do it in. Very glad you could make it. Now, hopefully tonight we'll even take a couple of calls. So what we're looking at here is Skype. Now, I'll give you my Skype address. It's Scotty.McClue on Skype. So that's Scottie McClue, but the dot in the middle. All right. So Scottie.McClue. Stephen Hotspur's watching. Andy McCrory's watching. Neil Tipping's watching. Dinky Doo Neil Law. Mark Jones is watching. Catherine Shaw. Dean Park. How marvellous. Donald Scott and Jim McIntyre. Now, we had a little technical problem at the start of the programme there, but we are here now, and but we're only here for about an hour. So, for goodness sake, tell everybody, tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 about Scotty McClue live on Facebook. That is the big one. Now then, Catherine Shaw. Hi, Scotty. How are you? Listening and watching in Southport. That is lovely, Catherine. Jenny, 10 o'clock sharp, she says. Absolutely, Jenny. You're late, Scotty. What happened? Yes, a little bit late tonight. Little technical problem, but not to worry. We're here now, and that's what matters. Hashim says, all right. Gary says, ah, good to see you, Scotty. Dinky-doo, sir. It's marvellous to be with you all. I hope you've had a wonderful week, and that you saw the promo this morning at 10 o'clock sharp, of course. There we are. Ashley Smedley's watching from Swansea down in Wales there. How marvellous. How are the tenors doing in Dowlas, I say? Jarvis Butler's there. He's saying fantastic. Dinky Doo from John Gray. And we've got Stevie McKenzie watching and Dennis Hamilton watching. So that's marvellous. Ian Cook as well. Glad to be with you. Glad you guys could make it. Giuseppe is there. They are sharing the video and letting you know that they appreciate it. Thanks very much, guys. Very much appreciated. If you've just joined us, a very warm welcome, of course. You're listening to Scotty McClue and we're live on Facebook Live. Sunday the 30th of October 2016. And dinky-doo to all of you, I say. Now, we can give you some shout-outs, so there's no problem with that. Ian Cook's watching up in Dundee there. Lovely to hear from you, Ian. Alan Mack, happy Halloween. And to you, Alan, of course, evening, sir, says Colin Edwards. Richard Frediani watching. Good evening, Richard, the country's top newsman there. Hi, Scotty. I've had to charge my phone, says Denise. I know, Denise, I had to charge mine as well. So there you go. And Moreland in Georgia, Christopher Rees is watching from Moreland in Georgia. That is absolutely fantastic, Chris. Lovely to hear you. And Rebecca Booth Waterhouse watching. Hello, Rebecca. Lovely to hear from you. And dinky doo. Some people are saying I should sit back a bit. They're seeing too much of my fizzog. All that sort of idea. Hashim and five others are sharing the video and saying they appreciate it. Kieran Fox is watching. Thank you, Kieran. Very much appreciated, of course. And dinky doo to you. Now, tonight, what I thought we'd do, we've attempted to do it before, but it didn't necessarily work out. But what we're attempting to do tonight is to make a couple of calls on Skype, or take a couple of calls on Skype. So we can look at that. John Paul Preston is watching. Dinky doo to you, John Paul, from me, Scotty McClue, and everybody on Facebook. Now, guys, while we're on for this hour, if you can busy yourselves telling 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 about Scotty McClue, sharing and sharing and sharing stuff. Very, very important. Right, here's John calling in the Skype. We'll take the call and see how it goes. Hello, John, can you hear me? Hello, John. Can you hear me, John?
Hi, Scotty.
How you doing, buddy? Are you okay?
I'm fine. How are you?
Now, can everybody hear John on the Skype, guys? Let us know. Good morning from Perth, Australia. What about this, John? Are you enjoying it? Hello, can you hear me, John? Ah, there we are. Popped out. Anyway, not to worry. We got a call and it was perfectly clear. So that was rather good. So there we are. So we know that the Skype is watching. Howdy, Scotty from Paxton and the Borders, says Terry Taylor. Jen Pirrott's watching. Hi, Jen. Dinky do evening, Scotty. Hi, Ellie, says Ria. Valdez. Charmaine says, hello, Scotty. Bob is watching. Stephen's watching. And Roy Brownlove's watching. Hi, Roy. Dinky do to you. And yes, the sound is perfect, says John Paul. That's excellent. And George McElraith is watching. Now then, we have lots to talk about tonight, so I hope you'll come on to the telephones and tell us what you want to say. Evening, Scotty from Derby. This is absolutely marvellous. Hi, Scotty. I hope you're well, says Chris. Chris Mackeson there. And to you, Chris. Absolutely dinky-doo, I say. Are you ready for the big tomorrow, says Ria? Always ready for the big tomorrow, Ria. Never a problem, I say. There we are. John Paul says that everything is sounding good on the Skype. My Skype address is scotty.mcclue. So there we are. And also Jim Morris is saying, hi, Scotty, how fantastic. We should have been with you all at 10 o'clock sharp, of course, but a little technical problem tonight. Excuse me a second. I haven't gone away. I am still with you. There we go. Marvellous stuff. Right. And also, we've got some water here. If you need a drink of water, do let me know. Is that an awful good water? Not at all, not at all. I know nothing, says Ellie. Jarvis says, just give it a chance, Scotty. Here on this side, no problem. A shout out from Callum, no problem at all. Ha 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 ha, says Ria. And ha 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 to you, Ria. So there we are. And now, what do you think of the newly signed EU-Canada trade deal, Scotty? I think it's fantastic. I think we should be signing all these trade deals. You can never have too much trade, folks. Loud and clear, Scotty says. Jim Morris, thank you very much for that. So, Kieran, I agree with the signed deal. I think it's tremendous stuff. It should have been signed a long time ago, of course. If you'd like to try and call me, then get your Skype downloaded. Very, very important. So there we go. I shall just see what's happening here on Skype. We like this, of course. I think this is all rather good. And you can actually get on scotty.mcclue, it is. Meanwhile, if you can busy yourselves on Facebook telling everybody about the programme, saying that we are live now as we speak. And I shall just see what goes on here. That was an excellent call. So there we go. I'm just feeding back to Skype. I think that's very important as well. And there we go. There's Skype in front of me here. So I've got Skype, right? You'll just have to wait while I juggle all this, of course. This is one of these technical things that you have to juggle. But it's marvellous. It's the McConnie moment. Scotty, what do you think of Hillary Clinton and the email scandal? Well, if she said it, she said it. We shall no doubt find out more. And what have we got here? Scotty, send me some Greggs and a haggis to Australia, says Remo Pasiti. So there you go. Tell us where you're listening in the world, folks, when you're coming on. That is absolutely marvellous. Mark Billington says, Scotty for president. Yes. Now, if I'd been an American citizen, then you would have Clinton, Trump and McClue standing there. And we did do a Twitter poll on it, and McClue scored 74%. So that's not so bad, is it? Hi, Scotty. Hello. How are you, says Sarah Carroll? I'm absolutely fine, absolutely fine. Mark Billington says, Scotty for president as well. Paul Mungle's watching. Ah, dinky-doo, Paul. Always lovely to hear from you, and I thoroughly enjoy your stuff on Facebook. And a big thank you to all of you for all your Facebook stuff, for putting up with me, of course, for sharing and sharing and sharing and sharing, for seeing the videos coming around and thinking, oh, for goodness sake, all that sort of stuff. But we're going to make it a regular slot, Sunday nights, 10 o'clock sharp, as I say, tonight. Tiny bit of technical trouble, but there we are. We're here now, and that's what it's all about. What time are you on till tonight, Scotty? I've just tuned in, says Steve Burrows. Steve will give it a good hour, I reckon. So there we are. Get Scotty on the BGT panel. Yes, Britain's Got Talent. We sometimes wonder, don't we? We look at it. But with my knowledge of music and drama, and 40 years experience, I'm sure we could manage something. Happy Halloween from Greenock, says Greg Mitchell. Fantastic. Thanks, Scotty. How are you doing, my friend, says Paul Mungle. Absolutely fine, Paul, as I say. We thoroughly enjoy all your email exchanges. Scotty, where is Gordon the Gopher, says Jarvis Butler. No, no, you're talking about the wizard of the big switchboard. Would you believe the wizard has actually been in touch tonight? The wizard of the big switchboard has been in touch live here on Facebook during this programme. That's excellent. The boys all passed their gas exams last week, says G. Hamilton. Fantastic, G. I'm very glad they did. So now they can come and do a bit of fitting. Hey, Rachel, says Jimmy. Hi, Jimmy. Now, guys, remember sensible stuff only for Scotty McClure, the message is. John Tom says, has anyone done the high dusting? Has anyone don't to do the high dusting? I think he means done the high dusting. Predictive text, of course. Hey, says Julianne Scott. Hey, Julianne. Scotty, this is better than the radio because we see your lovely face, says Neil Tipping. Dinky-doo to you, Neil. Fantastic. Joshua MacDonald. Aha, Callum. Dinky-doo, Scotty, says Lee Buckinshaw. Jamie Mallock says, aha, no way. Can you say hi to my mum, Anne Marie? She was born in Greenock, says Ian Cook. Somebody tried to correct me once. They said it was Greenock. You always know when somebody's from Greenock or Greenock because you can see their webbed feet. John Tom says, done, he sorted it out. Must have been a typo. And where do you think that will leave any future Brexit trade negotiations? Or has it already taken the wind out of such negotiations? Literally giving Mrs. May the old 1-2, says Kieran. Well, I have to say, there was a lot of talk this week about should we, because Brexit's based on a few whoppers, should we actually decide to go for it again? You know, like the old Scottish referendum, go for it again if you're not sure. Are you dressing up for Halloween, from Eddie in Bells Hill? Eddie, do I not look as if I'm ready for Halloween, for goodness sake? All I need to do is reach behind me and pop on my mitts. I think that's the best thing. John, it's not for breakfast, it's for lunch. So there we are. The Yanks should pull something to get, says George Mullen. Get the trade deals. Josh Callum, all I can say to you is if I get anything too silly, then you'll just be blocked. So please do not put anything silly on because I won't read it out and I will block you. And I had to block two or three people last week, so they won't be able to get the programme. And that's their own fault for being silly. So there we are. Your American people are signing in, says Alan Brown. Always love your banter. Can stay with you after the American elections. Scotty, for First Minister. How marvellous. Alan Brown in Washington there, just along the road from the White House. And Yvonne Boyd McLennan says, hello, Scotty, from Yvonne in the Scottish Borders. Al Gore should take over in America, says George Mullen. There's Hamza saying, dino, mate. John Tom's Brexit's merely an advisory referendum. It isn't legal until Parliament votes on it. Well, you'll need to tell the senior politicians that, John. So there we go. America should return to British control, says Remo Pacitti. Yes, do you know, Remo, I've actually said this for years. Does America want to go home to mama? That's what I've always wondered. Excuse me, you haven't disappeared again. Just doing a little bit of beautifying. Whew! My goodness me. It's warm in here tonight, so there we are. Gave myself a bit of a mop down. Something to get a better president. Sorry, Scotty, not a problem. Jarvis says, do you think the only solution in Syria would be for us to back off? Well, you had Boris Johnson this week saying that if we don't sell arms to Syria, someone else will. Is that a reasonable excuse? I don't know. Right. Do you think the only solution, yes, would be for us to back off? Well, Jarvis, it's something we'd need to look at. Paul Martin, you look as if you're heading for a ban there. Scotty, brilliant. Where have you been? And also, we don't like Clinton. You're a top man, Scotty, says Robert. Thank you very much, Robert. Very much appreciated. I can't get away with just how busy this show is, guys. This is absolutely fantastic. America, like over 100 other countries, brackets, close brackets, wanted independence from British rule. No country has ever wanted to come back to British rule. Well, I think that's absolutely true. Why would you, for goodness sake? And because, I mean, the British used to get in there and be very tough and then be kind. Right, Francis says, hi, Scotty, are you going back to the radio? We love your shows. And this is love from Tatty and Francis, who are in Grangemouth. Well, there are big talks on at the moment about me going back on radio. So fingers crossed, I say. Scotty, any single mums following you? Roy, stacks of them. They all follow me. Ree Borison selling arms. Blair's been selling them for years since he left office. So we say allegedly. Selling Surrey arms in the first place is the reason why it's in a mess. John Tom says, I love the tweet, as always. A lovely bit of fine Harris here, John. I think the Facebook guys and girls need to hear the Scotty Megamix, says Lee. Lee, do you remember the old Megamix? Dance with your granny and your auntie Fanny right across the floor. When you get to the other side, shut the flaming door. Should George W. Bush and his cronies be up for war crimes, Scotty? Well, this is something that you would need to look into. I don't think that's something we could actually say yea or nay to on a talk show. Pardon me. I'll just have a glass of water. Oh, that's awful good water there. It's gorgeous. Hardy-gardy in the windy boxes, says Paul. There's a moose loose about the hoose. Loved your radio jingle, says Gary Crossan. Alex Robertson's watching, dinky-doo to you. Hamza says a shout-out to Seb. Absolutely, James Kiddle's watching. My goodness me. And Lee says a live rendition, even better. Excellent stuff. Rema says, Scotty, if you go back on the radio, make sure to keep up the Facebook show so those of us in other parts of the world can still tune in. Yes, I am amazed at how popular this has become. Say hee-haw, says Hashim. Do you mean nothing? It's easy to become 5-minute famous nowadays, says Roy. Oh, absolutely. Thank goodness I'm 40 years famous, Roy, because I wouldn't like to just be 5 minutes famous. Gives a wee tour around McClue Heights. Who's on the photos? You can't shove your granny off a bus, says Ian Cook. Well, so they say, but you could shove your other granny off the bus because she's your father's mammy. Internet not so good here in Wales, says Julianne. And Andy says, do you ever hear from wee fat Bob? No. And who else have we got? We could always have a mix between the radio and Facebook Live. Well, I think this will happen. If my discussions come to fruition, then we will end up on the radio, which will have everything, all the social media linked as well. You've always been popular, says Steve. I'm from Swansea. You're very helpful, says Ashley. Oh, yes, of course. We look after our Welsh friends, you know. Yakida. Hi, Scotty. It's Wally Free Greenock. Wally Rennie. Hello, Wally. Hi, Scotty. It's Jimbo from East Kilbride. I hope you're well. Lots of shout-outs there. Now, I would like to try some Skype calls. So if you've got Skype, get it downloaded, latch yourself on to scotty.mcclue. In fact, I'll tell you what I shall do, if you don't mind. 2 seconds, there we are, and I'll just bring you round so you can see what I'm doing, because I know you get anxious if I go too far away from you. There we go. And what we will do there, right, John's sent us a contact request. Just give me a wee second here. There you go. I'm just sorting out a wee Skype thing, and there we are. Excellent. So there we go. That should be everything sorted. So that should be the Skype clear for all of you to come and Skype Scotty and give us your chat. My ma is watching, Scotty. She's behind you. Say goodnight to wee Rebecca, please, Scotty, says John. Goodnight, wee Rebecca. Dinky doo, off your bubbles. A shout out to Robbie Imrie. Well, why not? Scotty, are you standing up or sitting down? I'm sitting down, dear boy. If I was standing up, I'd disappear. So there we go. A shout out to Nisa. Of course, we can always have a shout out. And Hamza says, shut up, Callum. So there we go. Now you take his word. You take his word for it, I tell you, young man. You take a good telling. And make me, says Callum. Love it. A bit of banter going on the old Scotty McClue show here on Facebook. If you've just joined us and you're wondering what on earth is going on, Scotty McClue is live with you saying dinky-doo here on Facebook. We're here every Sunday night, 10 o'clock sharp. Don't be late now. I was a tiny bit late tonight because we had a little technical problem. My wife's just walked out. Does anyone know a good locksmith? She can't get back in. Very good, very good. What's the topic tonight, says Paul? Well, Paul, I was hoping to get some calls in. David Steele says, sorry, Scotty, I'm late. I'm just in from work, big chap, but I've only missed 17 minutes. I see, yes, we were a bit late tonight with a wee technical problem. A shout out to Michael Elliott, says Robbie Imrie. Yes, of course, Robbie. No problem with the shout outs, but the shout outs are all very well. What we need to do is start the calls. Bit late, says Ross. We are, Ross. We just said that. So there you are. You should be listening. Paul, I think Paul Martin's heading for a ban here on. We should just ban him just now. Shall we just ban Paul? There we are. If you come out with anything that's not proper, guys, or inappropriate, then what will happen is you will be blocked. So you won't be seeing any more programmes. Graham Stewart's watching. A very, very fine broadcaster there. Scottish broadcaster. Marvellous political presenter. So if you get a chance to see Graham Stewart, do that. If you can Skype me, Scotty.McClue, feel free to do that as well. Just see what's going on here. We've got equipment all over the place here. Devices everywhere. Can you say goodnight to my boy Kieran, says Sarah Carroll. Of course I can, Sarah. Not a problem at all. I've just sent you a wee Skype request, says James. So what we'll do, James, I shall just pop that over this side. Can you see? There we go. Are we all right there? And I shall just deal with your Skype request. There's no problem with that. So there we go. Skype there. Marvellous, marvellous stuff. And what we're doing there, that's great. And I'm just accepting people here. So anybody who's coming in here, not a problem at all, guys. You can all come on, add contact. There we go. So if you've sent a Skype request, we will add you on. That is not a problem. But if you want to try Skyping me, Scotty.McClue, and I shall take the calls, and we'll see how that goes. We should be able to hear it. We've done a bit of testing. And Finlay Wallace says, wet. What's or pardon it is, Finlay. Willie Rennie says, a taxi woman tried to assault me in Greenock. The nutcases. A taxpayer tried to assault you. Thank you, sir, says James Bauer. Not at all, James. Lovely to hear from you. I'm just disappearing for a second, but I haven't gone away. So you should be able to hear me. Marvellous, marvellous stuff. Oh, here we go. A bit of Skyping. Back on we go for the Skypes. Right, we've got Roy calling here, so we'll take Roy. Hello, Roy. Can you hear me?
Hello, Scotty. You're looking well this evening.
Ah, dinky-doo. Lovely to hear from you. What's happening these days?
I did a big magic show last night, and last week I did my auditions for Britain's Got Talent.
Oh, tremendous. How did you get on? I hope they were kind to you.
I'm through to round three.
Right.
And so that's a television audition.
Yep.
So will
we actually get to see you on the telly then, Roy?
Unfortunately, you probably will.
Good. No, that'll be absolutely fabulous. And you're working your magic, are you?
Yeah, I did a charity gig last night for prostate cancer.
Fantastic, yes. Excellent stuff. You're a great man. And you can't tell us about the tricks, but what's your favourite tricks?
The tricks I'm doing on Britain's Got Talent are mind control.
Oh, wow. Do you want to try a bit on here tonight?
Scotty, no one, I don't think, could ever control you. You're uncontrollable.
Well, we don't like to be too controllable, but the only thing is, as you well know, and you do know this, if you're an original, if you're a bit of a one-off in life, it takes a little bit for some people to get used to that.
That's right. You know? Scotty, we wouldn't have you any other way.
I was talking to a programmer recently, and I was actually saying, you know, once you get me, boy, do you get me. You know what I mean?
No, that's right, Scotty. Things have moved on a little bit. I mean, in the olden days, you know, your earlier days, you were very controversial. Trouble is now everyone's controversial.
Well, everyone's controversial, so I don't bother with any of that. So there we go. Boys, I'm just going to have a wee chat here. Boys and girls, if there's anything inappropriate or rude comes through here, then your problem is you will get blocked. Sorry, I was just telling them they're wrong. You have to explain to them. Some of them are so stupid they don't actually get it that if they said through something inappropriate, I shall not be having anything to do with that.
Scotty, soon your block list will be as long as your arm.
Apart from blocking one-offs, says Paul. There we are. We had to block a few people. I could see Declan getting blocked. I could see that happening. So there we are. There's a gentleman telling us that they've raised £640 for the South Lanarkshire College Events team. That's rather good, right?
We raised £3,500 last night.
That is tremendous. That's tremendous. And this was in Manchester.
No, this was in Leicester. Seven magicians gave their services free.
Seven magicians in one room.
That's right. Yeah, the magic was extreme last night.
Oh, tremendous. Now, tell me this, because people will be very interested, right? Do you swap tricks with other magicians? Is that allowed?
Yeah. You can actually buy DVD tutorial DVDs, but if I see another magician's trick, I adapt it to my style.
I remember the great Tommy Cooper so well, and even if people say, oh, for goodness sake, that can't be real, that's a trick. Of course it's a trick, but if it's funny.
Personality sells it more than the trick a lot of times.
Go on, right, tell us more.
Yeah, you need a good personality. I'm quite outgoing, I'm quite witty, so my tricks are normally a bit of a laugh.
Fantastic, we like that. So you're an entertainer as well as a magician.
Part-time.
Do you do a bit of singing, tell a few jokes?
Only time I sing is when it's 5 minutes before it's time to clear the room.
And that usually does it.
Yeah. It's the last number of the night.
Like when people used to say to me, do you do requests, Scotty? I said, of course I do. They'd say, would you finish your act outside, please? John, a joy talking to you, Roy.
Wrong one, Scotty. You should be on the stage.
Yeah, the next one leaving town to get excellent stuff.
Right, Scotty, I'll make room for someone else because they'll be queuing up to talk to you because you're rich and famous.
Well, all that stuff. And, of course, I have to tell you that I have sung for the Prince of Wales and the Duke of York, and there was another pub just next door. Lovely to talk to you. And listen, right, I hope it goes well and we see you splashed across the telly screens.
Thanks, Scotty. Thanks for tickling the ribs.
Dinky-doo-la-la. Dinky-doo-la. There we are. That's Roy calling from Leicester. He's a magician. Fantastic. You need to be to call from Leicester. So what have we got here? James Bauer says they raised it for breast cancer. Fantastic, James. Well done. John Tom says, where's the accordion? It would be great to have it on here. We might actually get a tune yet, to be quite honest. Brilliant getting the calls going, says Stephen Osborne. I was talking to a big friend of mine tonight, and he said, yes, you need some content on the programme. I thought, yes, well, we'll get that. That's something we'll get. So there we go. So if you'd like to Skype me, it's scotty.mcclue, capital S, C-O-T-T-I-E, dot, capital M, small c, capital C, L-U-E. So there we are. Unblock Elliot, says Ross. No, you can't. You must have said something rude. All we need is the lovable lassie, and we're back in a happy place, Scotty. Have some respect, Christopher, says Gregor. Yes, I think so. Absolutely. We might actually get the accordion and give you a tune one of these days. So there we are. And I can't unblock somebody if I blocked them because they've been rude. They've said something they shouldn't have said. So there you go. There's Christopher. Absolutely, Christopher. Dinky-doo. Christopher doesn't respect him. Quite right. David says, what about the draw-droppers, Scotty? Well, absolutely, yes. We need them to behave themselves. There was a talk this week about a male contraceptive coming in. And I thought to myself, no, I don't really think there's actually any need for that. People can just control themselves. That's what I said, control themselves. Shout out, yes, absolutely. There's lots of shouts out. And there's lots wanting a dab. I've just dabbed, not a problem. Scotty, fantastic. And a shout out to Harris, of course, no problem at all. So, we're taking calls now. If you'd like to Skype me, Scotty.McClue, get your Skype downloaded, get onto it, and give us a call. Also, tell us where you're watching this programme right now. Very, very important. So make sure you tell us where you're watching the programme. I think that is excellent stuff as well. And take off your hat, says Christopher. No, Christopher, I'm not taking off my hat. My hat belongs on my head. A shout out to the Swansea East Band doing a competition next Sunday for prostate cancer. So there we are. She's put prostrate. It's actually prostate. Prostrate is sort of lying flat and stretched out on the ground. You would be lying prostrate. So this is prostate. It's the prostate gland. That's what we're talking about. John Paul Preston in Glasgow, of course. Excellent. Livingston. Paul is in Livingston. Stuart's watching in Greenock. Alex is in Johnston in Scotland. Stephen's in Dalkeith. And this is fantastic. Stirling. There's Malcolm in Stirling. There's Callum, who says he's in his house. Hi, Scotty from Glasgow. There's Yvonne in the Scottish Borders. Craig is in Anbank. Julie says, soz, lol. Andy Grant's watching. Hello, Andy. Dinky doo to you. Johnston here, Scotty, says Andy. Yeah, fantastic, Andy. I go along with that. I think that is rather good stuff. And who else have we got? Let's just see. Give us a call if you want on the Skype. And we'll talk about things like that. So we're looking at that male contraceptive. Do you think men should be looking at contraceptives? Hold on, folks. Give myself a mop down. Whew. Very, very warm in here. Marvellous stuff, you know. Still summer in here. Still summer. You know, mind you, I'm broadcasting from Spain. I'm in Derby, not Leicester, Scotty, says Rao, says Roy. Oh, right. Fair enough. Right, here's Gregor calling. Hello, Gregor. Dinky-doo.
Sapnin.
Sapnin, Gregor. Excellent stuff for coming on. Well done, you.
Thank you very much.
Yes, we can hear you nice and clear, Gregor.
Hey.
Is that you on? Anything to say?
Yeah. 1 second. I had it wrote down.
You said what?
I've got a question wrote down.
A question written down. Yeah, go on.
From my mum. Here we go.
So there we go. Excellent stuff. My last cat just said hello. Cat is actually his daughter. I think it's a K. Did you know that shut the old Scott FM office in Bayliston, says George? I didn't, George. I'll tell you, that was a fantastic station. Scott FM, I would have said, was Scotland's finest radio hour. Right? That was a tremendous station. 50% music. 50% speech, and all your favourite tunes, and of course your favourite phone-in, Scotty McClue's massive mega phone-in. So who else have we got here? Guys, I'm seeing a lot of silly stuff. You've got a wee pint just out of view. No, no, it's water. Ah, let's see who this is. Remo! Hello, Remo!
Morning, Scotty, from beautiful Perth, Australia.
You're in Australia, Remo.
Yeah.
And you're in Perth.
I'm in Perth, yeah, the west coast.
Is the river the Black Swan?
It's not the Black Swan, it's just the River Swan, Scotty.
The River Swan, right, absolutely. Yeah. And I believe it's a beautiful, beautiful city.
Oh, absolutely stunning. It's quite a small city, but right by the coast, beautiful weather, 300 plus days of sunshine a year. Best place in the world to live, Scotty.
Stop it, Remo. We're just going into the winter here. And you sound as if you're a Scotsman originally.
Yeah, I'm originally from Edinburgh, but I've been here for about 5 years.
Wow. And are you loving it?
Yeah, absolutely. There's a big Scottish community here, actually.
All right. Would you suggest old McClure comes out and broadcasts in Perth, West Australia?
Oh, McClure, you clean up here, mate.
Do you think that the Aussies would go for me?
Ah, totally. Yeah, totally. I mean, we started this country, Scotty. Of course they would.
Absolutely. The Scots are the people, aren't they? I mean, they are really the old master race.
Yes, absolutely.
You know, if we're honest about it, they're the originals.
Yeah.
You know that we all actually came from the African Rift Valley via Ireland.
Oh, really?
So there's a wee bit of info. But that is fantastic. I love it. I love the concept of this program. That's why I decided to do it, to be quite honest with you. Because I thought to myself, this is amazing. This is worldwide. You know, yes, I mean, there's you in Oz watching.
Yeah, I mean, it's nearly 7 o'clock in the morning here. I've just woke up, about to have brekkie, fired on a bit of Scotty McClure, and yeah, it's a brilliant concept. So if you ever go back in the radio, I really hope that you keep the old Facebook live videos up.
Yeah, keep the Facebook going. Absolutely. Remo, fantastic to hear you. I'm going to let you go and get your breakfast. What are you having?
I've got some square sausage, actually.
A bit of square slice. Do they do the butcher slice out in Oz?
Aye, they do, yeah. It's a bit hard to find, but there's the odd Scottish butcher over here that does it.
Fantastic. This is great. I'm loving the sound of it, Remo, and thanks very much for your call. You know, you're one of the first callers. We've just had 3 or 4 calls.
Yeah, I heard the previous couple of calls, Scotty, yeah.
Tremendous, tremendous. I'll check with the nation that they can all hear you. Well, I'll check with the world that they can all hear you.
Brilliant, brilliant. Hey, thanks for that, Scotty.
See you, buddy. Bless you.
Yeah. Ta-da. You too, mate.
Fair dinkum. Right, there we are. That's Remo in Perth, West Australia. And Mark says, the options are brilliant this season. So happy you did, Scotty, says David. Fine, says Sufyan. Coming out tomorrow, loud and clear, says Ian Cook in Dundee. Fantastic, Ian. Thank you for that. That is great. What time are you on to, says George? Well, George, I'll just check. What time are we at now? My goodness me. We're 12 minutes past 11, but we were a little bit late in starting, so we'll give you a little bit more. Yes, he's loud and clear, says James. Terry says loud and clear. Got it, says Charles McLaughlin. Fantastic. And McLaughlin, Charles, thank you so much for your generosity. Guys, I've been bowled over by your generosity. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All of you who have donated to McClure's Wee Show, it is so much appreciated. You don't have to, of course, but if you're feeling flush and you think, no, I can find you a few bob, Scotty, because it helps buy little bits of equipment and lets us just do this, because we're doing it, obviously, on a little bit of a shoestring. But, I mean, it's phenomenal that this could just wipe television and radio stations off the face of the earth, because Facebook Live, if you can do it Facebook Live, why would you want to watch the telly? You know, why would Scotty McClure go on the telly when he's already on the telly? So things like that, you know, have a wee think about that, guys. Loud and clear, says Julianne. Yes, he's loud and clear, says James. Fantastic. Hi, says Kevin King. Hi to you. You're a star, dinky-doo, says James Barr. Fantastic. Lovely to hear from you, James. Guys, we know that the Skype is working now, so I shall just accept that there. There we go. So if you're wanting to come on, then get your Skype going. There's Glenn Thompson saying hi. Fantastic, Glenn. And a shout out to Ahad, says Ariane. Yes, no problem at all. Mustafa says, can I get a shout out? Of course you can. Mark Hesford in Manchester says dinky do. Lorna Meikle says happy Halloween, Scotty. I love Halloween because it's the one night of the year the missus doesn't have to dress up, so we like that. And Christopher says Gregor. So they're talking to each other on Facebook, guys. A shout out to Ryan's Mall. So there we are. Hi, Ryan's Mall. And you can watch telly as well with the sound down, says George Raffin, and just listen to Scotty McClure, George. Marvellous stuff. Did you like the promo this morning. How many of you watched the promo on Facebook this morning? Now, you need to do me a big favour as well. As I say, if you want to donate, www.scotty-mcclue.com. That's the Scotty McClue website. There's over 10 million people have viewed that website. Over 10 million people. Absolutely, absolutely up front. Incredible. 10 million people. The Scotty McClue website. Twitter. I don't know if you're a Twitter person. If you're Twitter, get onto Twitter and follow Scotty McClue. At Scotty McClue is so you can get on there. And Paul says, make contraceptive. It would be okay if I'd have a lovable lassie to be able to have contraception with. But I am not getting that. Fiona Brown's watching. Ewan McIntyre's watching. Mustafa says, happening, lol. Gregor says, Morven came in. Yes, fantastic stuff. I'm just saying, guys, keep it nice and clean. If there's anything inappropriate, then obviously you'll just get blocked. And that's silly. You don't, you know, the game's not so funny then when you can't get on to McClue at all. We've just had a call from Australia. I do like that. So there we are. I think Seth deserves a shout out as well. Come on, Scotty, says Ariane. Seth, I give you a shout out. So there we go. Very, very busy tonight. Tremendous. Now, during the week, as I say, spread the word. Tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 about Scotty McClue on Facebook Live. We're loving it, Scotty, says Callum. That is excellent. And are you liking the calls, guys? George Raffin says, no effing and jeffing. Absolutely, no effing and jeffing allowed. Happy, the legend that is yourself, says Willie Cross McPhee. Yes, you're very welcome, Willie Cross McPhee. And it's lovely to see so many people joining us here on Facebook Live. Can anyone explain where all the moths are coming from? I've seen 10 in my house over the weekend. And in Asia, it's said that the moths are dead relatives and friends visiting. Perfect for All Hallows Eve, says Mark. Mark, I was walking past clouds of midges in Scotland today. That's how warm it is. I was invited out to the country for a lunch. So there we are. Can Ibby get a shout out? Yes, calls are great and very clear, says Callum. Fantastic. Shout out to Dylan. Dylan's heading for a blocking. So there we are. And yes, I don't mind the shout outs, but I want to try the calls. So if you've got Skype, get to your Skype as quickly as you can. You might need to get accepted. Excuse me a minute. Here we are. We're still around. We haven't dashed off anywhere. Oh, my goodness me. Fantastic. Absolutely roasting in here tonight. It really is. So there we are. Just tidying myself up. Just nipped out. So who have we got here? Explain a daddy long legs then, says Paul Mungle, the daddy long legs. And you remember, I have to tell you what I haven't seen that you used to see in houses down south, just to smart myself up for you all, was the earwig or the eerie wig. Do you remember that? Was that a pet name for it, or was that its real name? Loving the one-liner, says Mike, no problem at all. And Paul Martin, no, Paul, we can't say that. So you'll have to come up with something a little bit cleverer, Paul, if you don't mind. A little bit smarter. We don't want too many dafties. Are you answering serious questions, Scotty, says Jarvis. Of course, Jarvis, if you've got a serious question, pardon me, you stick it through to old McClue here and we will sort that out. One or two people are going to get blocked at the end of the programme. Good evening, Scotty, says Denny McLaughlin. Good evening to you, Denny. George says, a crane fly. So the daddy long legs, of course, yes, it's all flooding back. You're quite right. The biology is flooding back. The daddy long legs was the crane fly. David Steele says, Scotty, what do you think of Brexit? Do you think Scotland should have Indy 2 vote due to the Brexit? Well, to be quite honest with you, I think Scotland should look at going independent because economically, I'm no political animal. I'm not interested in politics per se, but I do think that Scotland economically would do very well independent, because they give an awful lot of money, £40 billion last year, to the UK coffers, which is quite a lot of money for 5 million people, 5.5 million people. Hi, pal, says Alan Maitland. Hi, Alan, dinky do to you. If you want to give us a call, we're taking Skype calls. Scotty.McClue is the Skype. Feel free to come on, and we will have a chat. Is your dog with you tonight, Scotty? Yes, Yvonne. Lord Clyde is here. This is boring, says Christopher. Okay, bye. Bye, Christopher. Shall we just cut Christopher off? There we go. We'll just sort him out. Bye, Christopher. And David says, yes, I agree with you, Scotty. The Facebook page is a chasm of self-indulgent importance. Well, I would hope so, Paul, because that's what it's all about. Yes, I haven't seen earwigs for almost a decade. Years ago, they were all over the place. What happened to them? I had to laugh at some old fool that his page on Facebook, he was contacting me, and he was saying, it sounds like a wee bit of self-publicity. I had to laugh at that. I thought that was an absolute cracker. Absolutely brilliant to see you back, says Denny. Miss the good old Scott FM days. Au revoir, Christopher. Off you pop. Shout out, says Sikander. No problem at all. I'll have to get Skype for next week's show. Yes, you just download Skype. I think it's a problem. Block Callum, says Paul. Yes, we will do. Billy Matheson's watching. Dinky do, Billy. That's fantastic stuff. And Willie Cross McPhee says, whatever happened to wee Fat Bob? We don't know, Willie. I don't know what happened to him. I had some fish in my room the other day, silverfish. First time I've seen them in a year. You've got a dog, Scotty. What kind of dog do you have? I have a black Labrador, John. Everybody knows that. Yes, says Sikander. John Hewson is watching. Marvel's man, John Hewson, one of the finest marketing gurus in the country. Vicky Navarro says, hi, Scotty, and a kiss. Hi, Vicky. What do you think of Honey G on the X Factor? Is this not exploitation? Says George. Well, I don't know, George. Here we've got somebody Skyping us. Who is Skyping, I say? Joe. Hey,
sorry. Hello, Scotty. How are you doing?
Hello, Joey. Hey, how are you doing? Dinky Doolah. You're calling from Scotland.
I'm calling from Glasgow, Scotland.
You're calling from Glasgow in Scotland, and you're enjoying the Facebook show?
Definitely. It's one of the best shows I've seen ever.
This is tremendous, and I'll tell you, it's great of you to Skype, Joe, yes. Now, you look as if you're a bit of a sportsman.
You're the second person I've Skyped. I don't usually use Skype, you know.
I feel very, very honoured, Joe. That is very much appreciated. I can tell you that for nothing. This is the first night we've taken Skype. We had a couple of experimental calls, but they didn't quite work out the way we wanted them to. But everybody seems to be delighted with tonight, which means the phone-in's back.
It's coming through really clear at my end.
Is it clear that you can hear me?
It's very, very clear. It's actually about my telephone.
And I think we can actually hear you loud and clear as well.
I'm just using a tablet, Scott. Just using a tablet.
You're just on the tablet?
I'm just on the tablet now.
That's fantastic. That is absolutely... The technology is brilliant, to be quite honest with you, Joe. You know, it's incredible. I mean, when you think a television company used to cost millions and millions and millions of pounds to set up, you know, and just for a few pennies, we can produce a show like this, you know? There's somebody saying you've reversed the charges, Joe.
I wanted to talk about the Hillary Clinton email scandal.
Wanted to talk about what, Joe? Sorry, we just lost you a bit there.
The Hillary Clinton email scandal.
Oh, Hillary Clinton with the email scandal, yes. I mean, you know, I think, you know, there's some dreadful, dreadful stuff. There's some awful tricks going on with both candidates out there.
I know, she should be in prison right now.
Very, very interesting. There'll be a lot more comes out. Who do you think might win that election?
I think it's going to be Donald Trump.
Trump will win it, yeah. There's certainly a lot of mainstream media in America acting against Trump, because obviously Clinton's got the kind of track record in the presidential side, but it's not a very great one, is it?
It's a fair bit of action, but she shouldn't be running, she shouldn't be a candidate.
Yeah. Do you think he should be a candidate?
Hillary Clinton, she shouldn't be a better house, she shouldn't be a president.
Do you think Trump should be a candidate?
Not really.
Do you know what I'm going to actually let you go, Joe, and I'll tell you why I'm getting funny comments here. They're going, is he underwater? And I think you've got Darth Vader on Skype, Scotty. Fantastic. But listen, Joe, that's been tremendous. It really has, and it's great to hear from you, and it's live.
That's
what's wonderful. Take care of your good self, and we'll catch up soon. And as we say in the best of circles, Joe, dinky doo.
Dinky
doo. Fantastic. So there we go. That was Joe. Yes, it did sound a little bit as if he was under the water, but Bill and Ben on acid, says Teddy. So there are both candidates are very awful people. So there you go. It's fair to say neither Trump nor Clinton should be a candidate, says John Gray. Scotty, lovely 24-carat gold glasses. Yes, I'm advertising. They've actually got a car maker on the side. Can you see that? So there we are. We've actually got... I'll see if I can hold it up for you. I'd better not do any advertising, but very famous. Difficult to get it just... See if you can... There we are. Any help? Any good luck with that? Right, very famous car maker on the side of it. A car that I'm a big fan of. May the force be with him, says George. Great, Scotty, says Charles McLachlan. Thanks, Charles. And thank you to you, Charles. If it hadn't been for your kindness, I don't know where we'd be. That was great, Scotty. Thanks for taking the Skype, says John Paul Preston. Not at all. Absolutely fantastic. And if you want to come on to Skype, folks, we're now open for business in terms of taking calls. So I think we'll be seeing a lot more of this in the future. And of course, it gets the show up there. George Raffin says, an hour isn't long enough, Scotty. How much did you get the glasses for? I might get a pair myself. Shout me out, Scotty, says Daniel Ali. No problem at all. And Yusef, shout me out, says Yusef. No problem at all. Scotty, are you going to the concert, to Drake's concert, says Sikandar. The Gucci hat, says Ross. Oh, yes, nothing but the very finest for old McClure. Do you know what I mean? Got to smarten myself up for the notion. And why did you block Elliot, says Glenn. He was being silly, Glenn. What a great show, Scotty. Great to have Scotty back, says James. Thanks a lot, Scotty, says Danielle. Not at all. NJ McLean says, was he on the tablet or the macaroon? Ellen says, shout me out. Absolutely. So there we are. Paul Martin heading for a ban there, of course. Michael says, it's Oot the Barris on your glasses, Oot of the Barris. Scotty, what about space hoppers? Do you remember them? Yes, I used to use them, and I was a dab hand at going on the stilts as well, so I can tell you about that. Fantastic stuff. Now, couple of little bits of housekeeping. Thank you. Thank you to all of you for putting up with all the sharing on Facebook. Very, very important. And that's your job, right? It's my job to come on and talk to you and keep the world together. But it's your job to actually see that 10 get told to tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10. So there we are. The Space Hoppers, I remember them. Cheers for the shout out, Scotty, my man. Says you some pogo sticks, says Roy Brownlow. Absolutely. Great show, says Ewan. Say hi to Tiger Time for me, Scotty, says Paul. So two cans and a bit of string. Sod the stilts, says Denny. Now, the stilts weren't easy to get going, I can tell you that. It's one of these things that, as a wee one, a bit like international footballers, I was your international stilts man. I practiced and practiced and practiced until I could go the stilts. So there we are. Elliot says he's sorry. And Blockham says, Glenn, no, we don't know. You don't get two chances. Did you ever have a go at skateboarding, says Greg. Yes, but quite difficult for me to control that, actually. I feel a bit dodgy on the old skateboard. Scotty, you've got my missus hooked. Nicole Graham, give her a shout out. Brilliant, Scotty. Keep it up, says Robert. Dinky-doo. So there we are. Aleem, I spoke to you. Yes, you did indeed, Aleem. Scotty, can you do a show about the paranormal? Maybe tomorrow, says Mark. Gosh, this is paranormal enough for me, Mark, I have to tell you. And what's for supper, Scotty, says Roy. Oh, I think we're going light, you know, losing a bit of weight, you know, want to keep the jowls down. Still a young man, lots and lots to get through. They haven't even scratched the surface when it comes to broadcasting. So there you are. There's a lot of talk going on with some big players, guys, so fingers crossed there. See the mitts? There's the mitts tonight. A bit of dabbing for you. And also, Scotty, can you say hi to Adam? Yes, we can say hi to Adam. That's not a problem at all. Ha 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 ha, says Jack. Jack Orr. Right, how's the time doing? Because you lot will want to get to your beds. Oh my goodness me. Just about time to go. So there you are. Graham says, Scotty, I mind when you stayed in the cottages. My dad worked on the farm, and I was just a wee bairn. Oh, Graham, that is fantastic. Sober for October, one more night to go. Thank goodness, says George. Yes, indeed. And, well, McCold McClure here hasn't touched a drop since Christmas, so have a think about that. And Roy and 24 others have just shared the video. That's fantastic. That's fantastic. Oh, that's very good. A wee tongue twister there for you. Somebody said to me the other day, what does your missus do, Scotty? I said, well, it's kind of hard to say, really. She sells seashells on the seashore. Scotty, you're a legend, says Stuart. Absolutely. A shout out to yourself. Nearly Halloween, says John. Of course it is. David McGregor's watching. We like that. So excellent stuff there, and a fair bit of banter going on. Right, if you want to finish up with a Skype call, you'd be very welcome. Fantastic Glasgow band Rain Town, we must invite you to a gig next time when they're in town. I'll have a few on Tuesday, says George. Yes, absolutely, George. You're obviously celebrating having an alcohol-free month. We like that. Get the legendary back on the radio. We miss you. Absolutely. Getting a wee drink tomorrow, says John Paul. That is wonderful. I live across the road from the Bedford Picture Hall, Scotty, says George. Excellent, George. I've enjoyed this tonight, Scotty, says Vicky. And seashells on the seashore, easier to write than to speak. Absolutely. Elliot's very emotional over your decision, says Ross. Well, Elliot should have thought of that before he cheeked up on my Facebook. So there we are. But we'll maybe have a look at it. What's your Skype, says Yusuf? It's scotty.mcclure, Yusuf. S-C-O-T-T-I-E dot M-C-C-L-U-E. Scotty, what's your secret? You haven't aged a tad, says Jarvis. Jarvis, that is marvellous stuff. I'm a young man, of course, with a lot of years of broadcasting ahead. So there we go. A shout out to Danny. He's a dafty, absolutely. Any more Skype calls? I'll take one more call if you're quick, and then we're going to have to dash. So there you are. The Skype, scotty.mcclure. Elliot's got your picture on his wall, says Glenn. Excellent. Well, maybe we'll unblock him. And you should start the show with a wee tune, says Paul. Well, do you know, Paul, we talked about this, and I might bring the accordion up and give everybody a wee tune. Shout out to Harris, no problem at all. So there we are, we can do that. And I think that's just about it, folks. I thought we were going to get another Skype in, but it's tremendous. Remember, if you want to make a donation, www.scotty-mcclure.com. It's PayPal, you'll get a receipt. And thank you, thank you, thank you. It is very, very good of you and very much appreciated. And also, Scotty, get the accordion out, says David McGregor. Absolutely nice to see you back, Scotty. I'll be tuning in from now on. Great show. show, Scotty. Looking forward to next week. So there you are. What do you reckon to the new plastic fivers? Well, there you go. They're incredible. They should have Scotty McLean on the back of it. John Houston says, I'll see you when I get my glasses. Okay, John, stick out your tongue and say ta-ta. Scotty, you really are immortal. You sound the same as you did when I was 13. Ross says, an absolute class performance, as usual, Scotty. Fantastic. Charmaine says, good night, Scotty. Good night, Charmaine. Dinky-doo to you. I told you it's not long enough. It goes quick, says George Raffin. Yes, it does. It really is. So there we are. But we'll take calls. Get your Skype sorted for next week. Sorry we're a little bit late in starting tonight. There's a little bit of a technical problem, but that just doesn't matter because we're here now and we are global and that's what it's all about. Make sure you spend the week. Get on to Scotty McLew's Twitter if you're a Twitterer and follow me. And send in friend requests for Facebook. We may well be getting full up there. Remember, there's several Facebook pages, so look out for them as well. And what else can I tell you? As I say, thank you again for donating at www.scotty-mcclew.com. Your kindness is overwhelming, and we have just had such a response. It's really heart-touching. It really is. It's fantastic. I like the new fivers. Good night, Paul, says Paul. And to all of you, have a wonderful, wonderful week. Thanks very much for joining you. From me, Scotty McLew, and for everybody here at McLew Towers, may I say to you all, goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Take care, everybody, as you go. Goodbye, everybody, of Wiedersehen. Au revoir and a cheerio. Have a fabulous week, folks. I'll see you all next week at 10 o'clock sharp. Be there or be square. Until then, from me, Scott McLew, dinky-doo.